back by.
Coach Bass had a chicken pot pie for lunch. Actually, let me rephrase that. He had an entire chicken pot pie for lunch. Well, let me be more specific. He had a family-sized chicken pot pie and promptly fell asleep. We're all trying to be quiet not to wake him up before 2:47, which should be in about 5 minutes. All right, I'm going to change the computer. Can you change the watch?
I can do it.
What do you need me to do?
Normally, I don't condone skipping school, but today, I have an appointment with a horse doctor. How that horse became a doctor, I have no idea. I'm just kidding. It's just a regular doctor that shoots your horse in the head when it has a broken leg.
Like clockwork.
Oh my God. Guys, it's 3:00. What are you still doing here? Let's go home. Have a good weekend. Let's go. Come on. All right, bye guys. Have a good weekend.
Hello, and welcome back to another season of the Roundtable. I'm Amber Jones.
And I'm Clifton Raines.
We hope your school year is off to a great start, but if you find yourself struggling, here are a few tips to ensure your success.
These are the first of many videos that will stress our school goals of respect, responsibility, and determination.
One thing all high schoolers should know is you should never stop in the hallway.
And just so you know, you weren't supposed to get a school supply list before high school.
A good way to make friends is to join a club. For instance, chess club.
Never come to the school without a sweatshirt. It's just too cold.
Don't procrastinate, because before you know it, it's midnight and you still have chemistry, AP, and algebra homework.
Alexis, did you do the chemistry homework?
What homework?
Don't hold petty grudges. It makes it more awkward in the hallway.
Your counselors are there for you, so get to know them.
All the way, right?
I think.
But it does matter. It's a class.
Excuse me, Kate. You're late.
It doesn't matter.
But it does. These can potentially lead to detention or Friday school. Please don't be late next time.
The best app to get is QR Reader. It's free and it's very easy to use. Some other QR codes just don't work or freeze up, like this student's app. Once you open the app, you'll get to the screen, and you just easily scan the QR code and it will take you directly to your website. If you're leaving class, in the first page of the form, you will select leaving. Then you will fill out your last name, first name, where you are leaving, and where you are going. Lastly, check the box to indicate that you have permission. When you come back, you need to say that you're arriving and type your full name to indicate that you have made it back to class. Hopefully with the QR Reader app that we suggested, it should be this easy to fill out your form.
Next, we have Meet the Teacher, brought to you this week by our new members to the Level 3 team, Molly Ernest and Ava Welton.
Ooh, 90s jam. I'm gonna have to go NSYNC, It's Gonna Be Me, because I was a fan. I went to the No Strings Attached tour when I was in the sixth grade, and I like to meme it every May when it rolls around. So it's one of my favorite memes.
What were you like in high school?
Ooh, I often tell my students that I wouldn't be friends with me in high school. I was driven, I was into my music stuff, but probably a little more kind of obnoxious and arrogant than I am now. So looking back, I took everything really seriously. I don't think I would have been friends with me so much. Yeah. So college was definitely good for me.
What show do you binge watch on the weekends?
Oh, all right. So I just finally watched and finished Stranger Things. And a lot of my friends are making fun of me for waiting so long, but now it's kind of good because the second season's coming at Halloween, so I don't have to wait as long. But I usually just kind of skip around. I'm a little all over the place.
Well, who is your celebrity crush?
That's tough. I think for a long time it was Anne Hathaway, kind of like Devil Wears Prada phase, but then I kind of like fell out of that. So now if I had to pick, I'm probably like a Jessica Biel guy.
So what kind of career were you in before you began teaching at Norman?
So I've always kind of officially been in some kind of educator capacity, at least like in my professional years. But really before that, I mean, I got to tour and play a lot. I did a lot of kind of like the roadie stuff for a while for some different artists. John Legend's very first tour, before he was kind of anybody, I was the guy that came out and like checked all the keyboards and then like went off stage and did anything else. But I got to be a part of that team. And that's when I got hooked up with some other people that eventually landed some other jobs, and just got to see a lot of cool things.
How's the band doing this year?
The band is killing it, yeah. We're really excited about this season. We've almost tripled in size, and it's just been a really, really good season. We had our first band camp this summer, and it was really hot, but they absolutely killed it. We had everybody out there in the heat all day for that solid week, and they learned their entire show that week. And I love my band kids, I do. I get to teach a lot of different things here, but at the end of the day, that's kind of like where my passion is. And so when I get to be with those guys in rehearsal and in the stands and in performance, it really just energizes me, so.
That's great.
Yep.
We will now take a short commercial break, but we will return with a look into our featured fall sport of the week, the Lady Knight volleyball team.
Plus, a day in the life of a Nolensville student. We'll see you after the break.
share a smile. Share a hug, share a smile.
You get to keep it.
God, man, these headphones are so annoying.
Low pump, D-Rose.
Ooh.
100 on my wrist.
Low pump,
80 on my wrist.
Ooh.
D-Rose.
Hey.
D-Rose.
Hey.
Hey, 100 on my wrist, 80 on my wrist.
What?
100 on my wrist, 80 on my wrist. 100 on my wrist, 80 on my wrist. 100 on my wrist,
80 on my wrist.
D-Rose, 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 80 on my wrist, 100 on my wrist.
What?
80 on my wrist, 100 on my wrist. 80 on my wrist,
what?
100 on my wrist. 80 on my wrist,
100
on my wrist. D-Rose, 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 D-Rose.
There's a moment in your bones when the fire takes over. Blood is running, heart is pumping as the battle gets closer. They can say what they want now, 'cause we'll be screaming out. We can be heroes everywhere we go. We can have all that we ever want. Every spotlight, every soundbite, everybody who gave up is just a fuel for wanting him more than anybody against us. They can say what they want now.
All right, I'm Clifton Raines. This is the day in life of Brandon Wharton. All right, so Brandon, what are you looking forward to today?
Man, I'm looking forward to studying.
Studying?
Mm-hmm.
You study a lot?
I do.
What's your favorite class?
History.
History? Who's your favorite teacher?
Definitely Miss Miller.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh.
There she is. Is this her free period? She has homeroom, isn't she?
All right, right now we're going to Brandon's locker to see what his locker situation's like.
Yep.
All right, let's see how this goes. Right now.
Yeah, I don't know my locker.
Right now. All right, Rob, we opened Brandon's locker finally, and why isn't there anything in here?
Well, this is actually the first time I've actually been to my locker, so.
All right, let's go.
Brandon and I share a very special bond. I kind of view him as a second son.
Big Poppy Sheldon. How y'all doing?
In certain respects, he needs a lot of guidance. And last year I had him for 3 class periods, so I cherish that time that I had to mentor him and to really kind of bring him along and help him to become the young man that he is today.
We are.
Hey, let's go.
Nut.
Hey, leave me alone. Stop talking to me.
Hey, stop.
Big Pop Nut. Hello.
Stop. You're mic'd up again.
Open up.
Who's this filler? You doing a documentary?
Yeah.
You tell the time is now.
Time is now.
No more wasted time. Time is now.
Time.
Right?
Yeah.
19 games.
19.
That's what we're
That's all we got.
All right, now do some
random stuff. All right. There you go. You know I like that.
Like, Juliana was like,
I don't know.
Day in the life
of
the award.
Day in the life.
What are you having for lunch today, Brandon?
Yeah, it's the usual, but yeah. That's about it.
Wes, you want to say anything about Brandon?
Let this man say something about me. Do I need to give him the mic?
Yeah.
Sit a little closer.
Right. This man, Brandon, you know, he always buys me tater tots.
I do.
And mozzarella sticks.
Yep.
Where's the camera? All
right. The camera's right there.
Oh.
Mike's right there.
All right. Yeah, he's cool. Yeah, that's all I got to say. And his middle name is Eugene.
It is. Yep.
Who did
you just tell me, Phil?
Let's go.
One me.
Who? All right, come here. All right, what's the recap of the day? What are your favorite parts?
Favorite parts, man, every second of this.
Every second?
Every single class. I love all of them.
Really?
They're so amazing, yes.
What's your least favorite part?
Walking in the hallways. I don't even like walking at all.
You don't?
So, no, not even close.
You got any tips or a joke?
A joke?
Or just a tip, you don't have to.
Let's see. Always, always be sure to eat a lot of fruit snacks.
Fruit snacks?
The grape ones.
All right, thank you.
All right, you're welcome.
Now for a new segment this year called Know Your Boo.
We all know how adorable our NHS couples are, but how well do they really know each other? Level 2 students Reagan Spitzer and Dylan Stovall put them to the test. Enjoy.
Now we can't play on the table.
Well, that's awkward.
Yes, you write your own answer, and you're going to be writing what her answer is. Where was the first place you all kissed?
Oh.
This is going to be a weird answer.
Flip it.
Where's my place
now? Right foot.
And who made the first move? I'm so curious.
Okay, wait, no, there's a story behind it.
Oh, yeah.
She's pulled it right as I was about to.
Okay, sure. I was like, so, are you gonna do it or not?
I was about to, and then she
Okay,
whatever.
When is her birthday?
The month is like, I can't read it.
Flip.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
What is Heather's mom's full name?
Flip it. Beth Goodwin Klein.
Beth Klein. Sharon. Shin.
Sharon?
Yeah.
Oh.
I think he got the first name right. Yeah, he got the first name right.
What does MC complain a lot about?
Everything. I don't know how to spell it. Oh no, you're gonna get it wrong. Just write something down. Oh. Okay, doesn't that annoy everyone?
Doesn't annoy me.
I never leave you unopened. That's why.
Are you sure?
I am sure. It's gonna result in a breakup.
Aw, that was a good one. I put working out. I hate conditioning.
Everything in the entire world. You have a pet.
No, I don't.
It died?
My bunny?
Away.
How long do you think the both of you all will last?
We're done. I'm just joking.
I'm just joking.
All right, bye.
Flip.
Well, that's awkward.
Pretty funny. Who said I love you first?
Oh, I told you.
I love you. Bring it in.
I love you too.
Oh, sharing a good moment.
I was running, it hasn't happened, but
too late.
Has now.
Thanks for joining us for this week's episode of The Roundtable.
Tune in next time for all the latest in NHS entertainment.
Now it's time to get back to homeroom, but remember,
live by the sword.